Hey everybody, AngerBuzz27 here. I think this is probably the first YouTube video talking about crime. And today we're gonna be talking about a double parricide that occurred in Bellevue, Idaho back in 2003. Right now we're gonna be talking about Sarah Marie Johnson. And to be honest, it was probably the most tragic case of 2003, because it happened, you know, Labor Day weekend, actually the day after Labor Day, 2003. And her parents, you know, were found murdered. And the reason why she murdered them, because they basically barred her from being with a boy who happened to be a full-time drug dealer living in a bad neighborhood. And it was crazy. And when they brought her back, actually at one point before, like, I think it was like two or three days, the day before, two days before, I'm not so sure, but Sarah went to her so-called boyfriend's house. The boyfriend's name was Bruno Santos. To put a little humor into it, this made me think the movie Encanto should have came out around that time. It wouldn't have been better if it came out then. The reason why I'm saying that is because, you know, because of that song. You know what song I'm talking about.
We don't talk about Bruno, no, no, no. We don't talk about Bruno.
Okay, let's get out of the dry humor. Let's go to the more, you know, serious part. So, Sarah's parents discover her there. Well, yeah, both of them do. Her father and her uncle, who happen to be there as well, along with her aunt. So, her father and her uncle drive over there, and they confront Bruno. And they threaten to report him to the police and have him deported. Then they bring Sarah back home, and her parents basically ground her from that point forward. And when the family continued on with their family activities, Sarah continued to act out and decided to punish her family by having their activities ruined. Yeah, she decided to punish her family by having their activities ruined. So, yeah. I would never want to have my Labor Day ruined. Then the next day, the bickering continued until it got to the point when the first day of school was supposed to go on. She decided to avoid going to school altogether and flee with Bruno by shooting her parents to death. And when her mom was shot, a part of her head was just blown off. And when her dad was shot, he was shot in the chest twice. Then after, Sarah ended up, you know, claiming that an intruder came in, which was not true. And her behavior seemed odd. I mean, she was actually smiling at her parents' funeral, which, in my opinion, is totally abnormal. Something's totally wrong here. And DNA was found in the shower cap that she was wearing, a bathrobe she was wearing backwards, and gloves that she was wearing to prevent herself from being covered in blood. And it was crazy. In my opinion, if she had not run to that neighbor, she would have still been a free woman. She had not called 911. You know, it almost reminds me of the Jeff Pelley incident. This was almost similar because he was caught burglarizing a home, actually a few homes, I think. And instead of being arrested, he was sent back to his parents' house. Well, his home. He lived with his father, stepmother, and his sister and stepsisters. And his father basically grounded him for quite some time. And he was barred from going to the prom unless his father drove him. That was part of the punishment. And out of rage, he took out a gun that his father owned, fatally shot his father, his stepmother, and two stepsisters who were present at the house the day of the prom. Then he drove to the prom. He found the car keys and he drove to the prom in his Mustang without, you know, without any restrictions. And he didn't even call 911. So this would have been more like a Jeff Pelley like situation. Anyway, let me know what you think, and thanks for watching, and subscribe.